you say.
You'll have to forgive me if I seem a bit nervous. Not many people travelling in this part of Ferelden. Of course, that's part of my problem, isn't it? Mule got spooked by a wisp and ran off into the woods. Now what do I do? Well, yes. Oh, it's been quite the month. Allow me to introduce myself. Felix de Grosbois, merchant and entrepreneur at your service. I don't normally take this route, but with the war, I was hoping for a bit of luck and good weather in the mountains. Sadly, I've had neither. Ugh, this trip has been one miserable disaster after another. I don't suppose you consider helping a fellow out? Of all the other things that went wrong, the worst is this artifact I brought in Jada. It's a control rod, I'm told, for a golem. No point in me keeping it, however, as I'll never get to use it. But, maybe you could? Nothing. I just don't want to have to lug around something that might be taken for a gemstone by some bandit. To be honest, I don't even know if it'll be useful to you. I paid too much to simply throw it away. Just as well. You'll find the golem in a village named Honleith, in the hinterlands. Here, I'll mark it on your map. I've heard it might be dangerous there with all the darkspawn about, but I'll wager that's not an issue for someone like you. Just hold up the rod and say Dulafgar. That will wake the golem up, so I'm told. I hope it works. Best of luck to you then. Now, I guess it's up to me to find that mule myself.
Yes.
Indeed.
has begun.
Your friends are formidable folk, indeed. It's good to have you along on the road. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Cold in my tent, all alone. So you shall come to my tent? But whatever shall we do in that tiny little space together while we wait for it to warm? Good, then let us waste no more time with foolish talk.
Slow the sea,
I see the stories they tell of Grey Warden endurance are not exaggerated. Not at all. Legends abound regarding such figures as Garahel, sordid though they may be. The unanswered question, of course, is whether the endurance exists because of the taint within you, or because the Grey Wardens are by nature so very healthy. I enjoy the thought that 'tis a little of both. Natural prowess driven by a darker side. That is entirely up to you. Simply know that I have no designs on your independence. I wish only to do what I desire, and if that coincides with what you desire, then so be it. And should you decide not to continue our misadventure, then so be it. Very simple, is it not? Then we should get along marvelously. Come then, let us be off before the others begin to stare. What? You found Flemeth's grimoire? When I spoke of it to you, I did not truly hope... This is a most fortuitous event. You have my thanks. I will begin study of the tome immediately. I suppose something is deserved for all your efforts, is it not? I do not intend to squander this opportunity to learn more than Flemeth wished me to know. This should be interesting. I notice that you are spending a great deal of time with that girl, the bard. I'm not opposed to the girl. She seems agreeable enough for the sort of man who likes that sort of thing. My point is that you and I have shared a bed together. It seems hardly fitting to have you doting upon that girl at the very same time, does it? And yet the evidence speaks to the contrary. If you feel nothing for the girl, your actions say otherwise. The crux of the matter is this. I do not share. If you wish to pursue that girl, that means you do not wish to pursue me. 'Tis all the same to me. I will not be where I am not valued. I simply wish to know where I stand. Then you need to say that to Leliana. Sooner rather than later. Ah, and before I forget my original thought, I have something for you. I mean that I have a gift for you. 'Tis a ring. Now, before you get any foolish notions, let me explain. Flemeth once gave me the ring because it allowed her to find me no matter where I went, in case I was ever captured by hunters. I disabled its power as soon as we left the wilds. Recently, however, I thought to change it. Now, I will be able to find whoever wears it instead. It is not given out of sentimentality. I believe you were too important to risk. If you were captured, this ring would allow the rest of us to find you quickly. Then here, take it, and let us not speak of it further. I have something for you. 'Tis a ring. Now, before you get any foolish notions, let me explain. Flemeth once gave me the ring because it allowed her to find me no matter where I went, in case I was ever captured by hunters. I disabled its power as soon as we left the wilds. Recently, however, I thought to change it. Now, I will be able to find whoever wears it instead. It is not to track you, you understand. I believe you are too important to risk. If you were to get captured, however, it would be far easier to find you with this. Then here, take it, and let us not speak of it further.
Something on your mind?
Of course. Others, yes, but not yourself. I need someone who's trained first as a warrior. It's as much about discipline as anything. I guess if I'm going to give up Chantry secrets, I may as well go all the way. Send whoever you want trained to me in camp, and I'll see what I can do. Something on your mind?
Of course.
Did I say that? I meant that dogs raised me. Giant slobbering dogs from the Anderfells. A whole pack of them, in fact.
Well, if you're going to go and pay attention to the facts, then fine, fine. Let's see, how do I explain this? I'm a bastard. And before you make any smart comments, I mean the fatherless kind. My mother was a serving girl in Redcliffe Castle who died when I was very young. Arleman wasn't my father, but he took me in anyhow and put a roof over my head. He was good to me, and he didn't have to be. I respect the man, and I don't blame him anymore for sending me off to the Chantry once I was old enough. Arleman eventually married a young woman from Orlais, which caused all sorts of problems between him and the king because it was so soon after the war. But he loved her. Anyhow, then you, Arlesa, resented the rumors which pegged me as his bastard. They weren't true, but of course they existed. The Arl didn't care, but she did. So off I was packed to the nearest monastery at age 10, just as well. The Arlesa made sure the castle wasn't a home to me by that point. She despised me. I suppose you're right. I wasn't raised as the Arl's son, though, if you're picturing that. I slept in hay, out in the stables, not on silk sheets. I remember I had an amulet with Andraste's holy symbol on it. The only thing I had of my mother's. I was so furious at being sent away, I tore it off and threw it at the wall and it shattered. Stupid, stupid thing to do. The Arl came by the monastery a few times to see how I was, but I was stubborn. I hated it there, and blamed him for everything. And eventually, he just stopped coming. I think so, yes. This news we've heard about him being sick disturbs me, though. I wonder if we won't discover that Loghain has come to the same conclusion as we have. Anyway, that's really all there is to the story. Something on your mind? Of course.
Have you seen the uniform? It's not only stylish, but well made. I'm a sucker for good tailoring. That's just in public. In private, we have these yellow and purple tunics, right? Much more comfortable, and you don't break the beds when you jump on them during a pillow fight. You don't really want to know about my being a Templar, do you? It's really quite boring. Poke, poke, poke. Tell me everything about your life, Alistair. All right, if you insist. It's not like we have anything better to do, right? The truth of the matter is that I did hate going to the monastery. The initiates from poor families thought I put on airs, while the noble ones called me a bastard and ignored me. I felt like Arleman had cast me off, unwanted, and I was determined to be bitter. But I took some solace in the training itself, I guess. I was actually quite good at it. The education, mostly, but also the discipline.
You need to have a disciplined mind in order to use the abilities we have. It was difficult, but rewarding. I never really felt at home anywhere, though, until I joined the Grey Wardens. And Duncan felt my Templar abilities might be useful for when we encountered Darkspawn magic, so I kept it up. What about you? Do you have anywhere you consider home? We won't always be traveling like this, you know. Once the war is over, once the Blight is... Well, a time will come when we'll have to think about having a real home again. Though that seems like a far ways off. And I suppose the Grey Wardens are gone for good, either way. I suppose you're right. We can create new Grey Wardens, but we'll never get back those we lost. I wonder if it would ever feel the same. Anyhow, now I've sidetracked us. We'd better get back to what we're supposed to be doing right now. Something on your mind? Of course. Such as they are. That's a good question. There's plenty in Orlais, but who knows where they might be found. And the nearest Orlesian city is weeks away. If we go north and cross the sea, there's bound to be some in the Free Marches. Again, however, I just don't know where. I don't know anything about Grey Wardens in other lands. Here in Ferelden, there's our compound in Denerim at the palace, but that's it. Loghain will have control over that and be watching it, no doubt. Beyond that, the only place I know of is Weishaupt Fortress. That's the headquarters of all Grey Wardens in the Anderfels, 1,000 miles from here. But I've no idea how to even contact them. So unless we try to get back to the compound in Denerim, I suppose the answer is no. There's nowhere for us to go. I imagine that eventually the Grey Wardens outside of Ferelden will wonder what's happened. Why there's no contact from Duncan or someone. They'll send someone eventually. Though who knows what Loghain's people in Denerim will tell them. Maybe they won't send anyone. We could try to contact them. But that would mean leaving Ferelden, and even if we did, they couldn't come back with us in time to stop the Blight. So that means whatever happens, it's up to us. I mean, eventually we would have to use the joining to make more Grey Wardens, right? But I don't know how to do the joining, or what's involved. I know it involves lyrium and some other magic and that it's really difficult to prepare, but that's it. Unless we can find out more about the joining, I guess we better get used to the idea that there might only be two of us for now. Until more come from elsewhere. Just left? You mean just left Ferelden? I don't know. If there's an archdemon, however, we're supposed to be the only ones who can defeat it. And that means the Blight would grow unchecked. Eventually, other Grey Wardens in Orlais and other lands would hear about it and they would come to fight it, but they wouldn't come in time to save Ferelden. There's no way. I'm not going anywhere. About the Grey Wardens, anyhow. Fair enough. Something on your mind? Of course. Same way you did. You drink some blood, you choke on it, and pass out. You haven't forgotten already, have you? Let's see. I was in the Chantry before. I trained for many years to become a Templar, in fact. That's where I learned most of my skills. You're telling me I was banished to the kitchens to scour the pots more times than I can count. And that's a lot. I can count pretty high. The Grand Cleric didn't want to let me go. Duncan was forced to conscript me, actually, and was she ever furious when he did? I thought she was going to have us both arrested. I was lucky. I don't know. Maybe. When he came looking for recruits, I just remember praying fervently to the Maker that he would pick me. I'll always be thankful to Duncan for recruiting me. If it hadn't been for him, you know, I wouldn't have. No, it's... I'm sorry. I shouldn't be. It's fine. He died a hero. They all did. Come on, let's go. I think I'm done talking. Something on your mind? Of course.
Never what? Had a good pair of shoes? Oh, so that's what we're talking about. Well, if you really want to know, you tell me first. And apparently you have no shame as well. Well, all right, I'll play along. I myself never had the pleasure. Not that I haven't thought about it, of course. But, you know. Well, living in the Chantry is it's not exactly a life for rambunctious boys. They raised me to be a gentleman. That's not so bad, is it? I've no urge to rush into anything. We may not even survive what is to come, after all. Enough. I don't want to talk about this anymore. Let's go.
I shall treasure it. Thank you. I shall treasure it. Thank you.
Unexpected. Thank you.
That looks fine indeed.
Oh, marvelous.
I enjoy the nights at camp. The night always seems more peaceful to me, safer. I feel the night grants us a reprieve from the troubles of the day. Silly, isn't it? The darkspawn never sleep, and they lurk in the shadows. I enjoy those nights when we stand guard together, talking to pass the time in those small hours. Well, I talk and you listen, mostly. Sometimes, I succumb and fall asleep and wake to find you still watchful. And I know you're watching out for me. What I'm trying to say is that I trust you. I'm comfortable around you. I know you'll be there when I need you. You are our leader and my friend. And sometimes I think that maybe we could be more than that. Maker, look at me stumbling over my words like an ill-educated peasant girl. Some bard I am. I'm not embarrassed. I'm just flushed because of the heat. Really? No one told me. You felt the same way and didn't do me the courtesy of informing me? You made me say all those things. Why couldn't you have said them first? Oh, you... Oh, how very awkward. Well, yes, but don't question me. I am a woman and I reserve the right to be inconsistent. Oh, chivalry is so dead, making the lady spill her guts like that. Well, that settles it then. I was just thinking about what happened to the elves, and I'm reminded of a song sung to me many years ago. It was when my mother died, and this wise elven woman comforted me and told me that we shouldn't fear death or hate it. Death is just another beginning. One day, we must all shed our earthly bodies to allow our spirits to fly free. It's a beautiful sentiment, I think. One that brings peace and hope to the grieving.
There you are. Wanted to talk to you. You and I, we've... You know how sometimes you spend time with people and things? I was thinking, I do know some people out here on the surface. A person, actually. The girl I knew in Orzammar, before I left, obviously. Her name's Felsi. She and I were friends after Bronca left for the Deep Roads. I'm sure she's forgiven me by now. Thought maybe I'd track her down, see how she's been living. I tried to look her up the last time we were at Lake Kalanhod. She wasn't at work at the inn. At home with her sick mother, they said. I figured it was just the ancestors telling me something. But I keep thinking about her. Well, and a good friend you are, Warden. I'll think about you if we ever... No, actually, that would be gross. No, what was it you wanted to say? You want to be a berserker? Thought I'd never see the day. You're a monster on the field already, Warden. But your style just doesn't give itself to mad rage. Too much thinking, too much... finesse. But if you know someone fit for this type of work, I'll teach him. It'll be nice to have another berserker to grunt at for a change. If you want to think like a berserker, drop fair from your vocabulary. If it works, that's all. Aye, all right then.
Here I am. Oh, this should be good. What would you like to discuss? Here I am. Oh, this should be good. Go ahead. Well, the crows would have you believe that it is an involved process that takes years of training, the sort that tests both your resolve and your endurance. Survive that process, and maybe, just maybe, you're good enough to start being considered one of them. But quite frankly, the truth is that all it requires is a desire to kill people for a living. It's surprising how well one can do in such a field. I don't know about that. It's simply a slightly different skill set from your average killer, as I see it. An assassin simply specializes in striking from stealth, and in maximizing that first attack to be as lethal as possible. Debilitate your foe, either by poison or by crippling their limbs, makes any follow-up combat you need to engage in that much simpler. See? Getting paid for the act is beside the point. An assassin is more a tactical choice than a lifestyle. Of course, the crows like to pretend that their abilities are trade secrets, shrouded in shadows and wrapped in a blanket of mystery. So let's just keep this between you and me, shall we?
You are not quite as callow as I thought. That is unexpected. You're welcome. I caged myself. A weak mind is a deadly foe, as you are no doubt aware. That is complicated. I told you before that I was sent here. I was not sent alone. I came to your lands with seven of the Beresad, my brothers, to seek answers about the Blight. We made our way across the Ferelden countryside without incident, seeing nothing of the threat we were sent to observe. Until the night we camped by Lake Kalanhad. They came from everywhere. The earth beneath our feet, the air above us. Our own shadows harbored the darkspawn. I saw the last of the creatures cut down, too late. I fell. I am told no others survived. I don't know how long I lay on the battlefield among the dead, nor do I know how the farmers found me. I only know that when I woke, I was no longer among my brothers, and my sword was gone from my hand. Perhaps. I searched for it, and when that failed, I asked my rescuers what had become of it. They said they found me with nothing. I did. I knew they didn't have the blade. They had no reason to lie to me. I panicked. Unthinking, I struck them down. Do your people have no souls as we know them? Convenient for you. That sword was made for my hand alone. I have carried it from the day I was set into the Beresad. I was to die wielding it for my people. Even if I could cross Ferelden and Teventer unarmed and alone to bring my report to the Arashok, I would be slain on sight by the Antam. They would know me as soulless, a deserter. No soldier would cast aside his blade while he drew breath. If I knew where to look, it would be in my hand now. Near Lake Kalanhad. Perhaps those words are empty, but thank you all the same.
Enchantment? Enchantment!
Yes.
Yes.
Indeed.
Isn't that the point?
A little something extra. For friendship.
Exactly. You. I. Everything.
It has begun. All a dream.
But whose dream? And for whose amusement?
Good day.
What are you looking at? Can a man drink in peace?
What can I get for you? And don't say mead. We ran out of that a week ago. And don't say rum, either. Ran out the day before yesterday. And don't say brandy. Have you seen how desperate people are now? They just want a drink to forget what's happened. Some ran out of coin and started paying in food, chickens, whatever they had.
Felsi! I need tables clean, girl!
I've got a customer. Aye, who wants to know? And you admit it? You don't smell drunk. Get kicked in the head by a Bronto, did you? What happened? Is that a serious question? Have you met Ogryn? He got drunk. Drunker than usual, even. Took off his pants and challenged a roast nug to a wrestling match at my father's funeral. He lost, by the way. The roast got him in an arm lock. He sat there crying for a half an hour before someone pulled it off him. It was a sodding good roast.
Felsi, what in Andraste's name are you doing? The tables, girl!
All right! I've got to get back to work.
Vashadin.
I got work to do. I don't need to think about that sodding waste.
There she is. I'm gonna go talk to her. Look, you gotta back me up here. Got it? Thanks, Warden. Just be ready to pry her off when she throws herself at me. We don't want to make a scene here. Well, don't pry her off me too soon. I mean, a little scene's all right. Are you sure you're not a baker? Because you got a sodding nice set of buns.
Well, look what the nug dragged in. I should have known you were in the neighborhood, by the stench. What are you doing here?
Just trying to kick back with a pint. Fighting Darkspawn's a lot of sodding work, you know?
You're fighting Darkspawn?
It was a bit of pain, but it was a personal favor for the King of Orzammar, you understand?
The whole surface to choose from, and you just happened to come to my tavern?
What? Oh, right. It's fate, Felsi. What can I say?
Fate? The ancestors must have a sense of humor, then.
Sure they do. You've had a good look at Lady Helmy, haven't you? If her face isn't a joke the ancestors are playing, I'm a Bronto's behind.
So, Lady Helmy must be a paragon of beauty, then.
I've been thinking about you, Felsi.
What do you want, Ogryn?
Nothing. Just thought I'd see how you were doing is all. Well, maybe that and grease up the Bronto, if you know what I mean.
Well, you've seen me. You'll have to go back to Orzammar for the Bronto. Oh, the Queen needed a new fool, did she?
Oh, well, it's been fun, Felsi. But I better go.
Wait, you're leaving? You just got here. I haven't called you a shaft rat yet.
Well, you can't keep the Archdemon waiting. You hurt its feelings and might just turn the whole blight around and go home. Nobody wants that.
Well, you don't need to fight it right now, do you? I mean, you could have a pint first. You could call me a surly Bronto. I could tell you that you smell like nug droppings.
I'll tell you what, I got some things I gotta do, but I'll come back for that pint when things are settled, you frigid deep stalker.
Fine, but you better not keep me waiting, you worthless copper-plated swordcast.
Wouldn't dream of it.
Yes.
Back off! I was here first! Why, you looking to buy one? Oh, is he? Well, that's... See, I'd like to sell you one, but I don't, have any myself. I got part of a glove the wolves didn't chew too badly, though. I think it was a glove, anyway. I know, don't say it. I got cheated. I knew the guy who was here before me. He sold me this spot. Said he found giants and all kind of crazy valuables. He didn't mention that he'd taken everything but the bones and the dirt already. His name's Ferrin. Squirrely little bastard, if you ask me. Which you didn't, but I said it anyway. He was going to Orzammar, he said. I imagine he's gotten there by now. If you find him, tell him I sent you. It'll scare the piss out of him.
I shall do it.
Have you seen my lunch? It's a piece of lichen bread with a spread of old cheese and shredded dried meat. I'm only asking because you never know who's going to get hungry. Right, best in the trade, you know. I work the ore myself.
I can't believe that scheming Harrimond stole the throne. Now his taxes will bankrupt us to pay for his wife's diamonds. Are you here to buy something or what? I'll take your gold. You're good for that.
Begun.
You do not truly think I look as my mother does, do you?
Have you really been thinking about that all this time?
I am simply curious.
And not insecure in the slightest, I'm sure.
I think I look nothing like her.
I don't know. Give it a few hundred years and it'll be a spot-on match.
I said that I look nothing like her.
All right, got it. Totally different. I see that now.
For the love of Aragorn.
So, you're back, I see. What can I do for you? You've, heard of me?
Where is my sword?
I don't know what you mean, sir. I don't have it, I swear by Andraste's knickers. I sold it on the way here. A dwarf near Redcliffe, Dwin, I think his name was. I don't rightly know. He said he was a collector. It's none of my business what a person wants with my merchandise once it's changed hands.
We'll see.
I've told you what I can, I swear to you. Oh, certainly.
Yeah?
Be done. I shall do it. As you say. Very well. As you say. I shall do it.